Changing text case. Sometimes in the document you want to change the case of the text. The text is written in small letter, you want to write it in capital letter. How will you do it? Will you erase all the text and write again? No. We'll use change case option. The change case option is available in home tab. In the home tab, change case option is available. See here, under the font group, this icon is the change case option. The keyboard shortcut of change case option is Shift plus F3. When we click on this down arrow, we see 5 change case options are here. Sentence case, lower case, upper case, capitalize each word, and toggle case. Sentence case, you are familiar with it. The first letter of the sentence will be capital. Lowercase, all small letters. Uppercase, all letters will be capital. Capitalize each word means each word's first letter will be capital. And toggle case, each word's first letter will be small. How to use this option? How to use this change case option? Let's see. Suppose I am selecting here, let's see, I am going to select this first line, first two line. First change case option, by default they are in sentence case. They are automatically in sentence case, so I am clicking on lowercase. What will happen? Only the first letter of the sentence will be small. See, the on, O of on is small now. And Y of U is again small. Now next I'm making it red so that you will see difference between all the cases. So next two line I have selected next two line. Now move to the next case, uppercase. What will happen? All the letters will be in capital. See, all the letters are in capital letter. I'm making it blue in color. Okay, now next two lines I'm clicking on change case option and click on capitalize each word. What will happen? Each word's first letter will be capital. See, picture P, chart C, O of R, and then the P, A, C, all the first letter of all the words are capital. Okay, again I am changing the color of it, this making it okay, different color. Now next two lines again go to the change case option. Next is toggle case. What will happen in this option? When we'll apply this option, the first letter will be small of each word. Click on it. See, U of Y, Y of U. Okay, in this case what happened? Toggle case. In this toggle case, sorry, it has not worked. In the toggle case, the first character of each word will be small, but my computer has not done it. Shift plus. We want to show the text in the form of number, we use numbering option. Bullets and numbering are used to show the text in the form of points or number. There are two type of list, number list and unnumbered list. Number list, where numbers are marked in the list, and this number list is also known as ordered list. Whereas bulleted list is known as unordered list. Means there are two types of list, ordered list and unordered list. Ordered list, where we required particular order, like your class, names of the student of your class. Your names are written roll number wise. So this list, student list, is ordered list. But if you are writing the names of any items in your classroom or any particular item, your parents are making grocery list, Then that time they are making the list of the item that they have to purchase from the shop. So this type of list, there no particular order is required. So such list is known as unordered list or bulleted list. How to use bullet and numbering option? Let's see. Here I have two lists. One list contains computer parts, and the names of the computer parts. All the computer parts are here, or you can say computer hardware. We can suggest it as hardware. List of computer hardware. And one more list I have, names of students. Student's name. Okay. Now, this two list, no one list has any bullet or no one number. These lists are two type of list. This list, computer hardware, here I don't require any particular order. So I can mark here as points. So to make it a list, what can I do? I can use bullet option. It is unordered list, so I'll use bullet option. This bullet and numbering option is available under the home tab in the paragraph group. In the home tab in the paragraph group, you'll see this icon. This is bullets. When you'll click on this arrow, you'll see bullet list. Here this symbols can be used to mark in front of the text. So I'm marking using this bullet. Okay, so this is my unordered list or bulleted list. Now next list, I have students name list. Here this list I require, this list, suppose I'm giving the strength of the class, I'm giving the names of the student, those who have attended the class. So here I required particular order, how many students has attended the class. So I'll mark it as number list. I cannot mark as bullets here. So what I'll do, I'll select this list, names of the student. I'll select all the names of the student and then click on next to the bulleted list. There we have number list. See, click on number list, you will see different formats of number list, 1, 2, 3 with brackets or ABC or in Roman. Whatever you find good, you can say. I have selected this. Okay, so this is my number list and this is my drop cap. Drop cap option allow you to display the first character of the paragraph in large capital letter, which enhances the appearance of the paragraph. Means the first letter of paragraph, you can enlarge the size of the first letter of the paragraph. You must have seen in a magazine, in the newspaper, the first letter of paragraph is very big in size. You may find that letter in the margin or at the left top corner. So how to use this feature? Let's see. Here is my word file. This drop cap option is available in the insert tab. Click on insert tab. Where is drop cap option? This drop cap option is available in the text group. Insert tab, text group. See, the drop cap option is here. Click on this option. When you click on this option, it shows three sub options. None means not applied, as we have not applied this drop cap option. No drop cap feature is applied here. Then next is dropped, and second in margin. So how will we use this feature? Let's see. I'm here at the beginning. Here my cursor is at the beginning of the paragraph. I'm clicking on dropcap feature, dropcap option, clicking on dropped. See, the first letter is O of para. This, when I clicked on dropped feature, the first letter covers the first three lines. Okay, but when I'll click on in margin, see what happens. The first letter is bigger inside, but it occupies in the margin of the page. So you can apply any one of the option of drop cap or this dropped or in margin to change the look of the paragraph. Changing the line spacing. Students, you can change the space between two lines. In the document, you see when you type, the text is very closer to you, to each line. If you want to change the, increase the space in between the line, you can do it. For this, we'll open the Word file. And in this Word file, see where is the drop line spacing option. Line spacing option is available in the home tab under the paragraph group. This is line spacing option. When you click on line spacing option, but before you click on line spacing option, you have to select the para or the intent. You have to select the lines in between which lines space you want to increase. So I'm selecting this para and click on the line spacing option. See, different line spacing options are here: 1.0, 1.15, 1.5, 2.0. When you click on, you can see the difference. When I'm bringing my mouse, when I hover the mouse on this options, you see the difference space between the line. So you can adjust the line spacing as per your choice. Generally we use 1.15. Okay, it gives clear look. One gets very closer. 1.0 will be very closer. So this way we can use line spacing option. How will we find? Oh, sab galat hai abhi tak ka. Adding page number option help us to add page number in our document. This option is very useful when we want to take printout of any particular page. If we don't know the page number, we have to look for the particular, scroll down and look for the page, and then we give the print command. And even if we are taking all the print of all the pages, we have to arrange them in sequence. To arrange them in the sequence, we also required page number. So how will we find out which page print of which page number is it? For this, we can add page number in our document. How to add page number in the document? Let's see. This document, I have this document, and this document is very big. Almost of 25 pages. Yes, see, and we are on the status bar shows the number of pages in the document and the words also. See, where we are on the page number 2 of 25 page, second page of 20, all out of 25 we are on the second page. Okay, so how to give the page number in the document? This status bar shows automatically. For this, what we'll do, the a page number option is available in the insert tab. The insert tab under the header and footer group. Page number option is available. Click on this page number option. It gives sub option where you want to add the page number. The top of the page, at the bottom of the page margin, or at the current position. Okay. So generally we use bottom up page. When you'll click on bottom up page, again you'll see the samples at the left, and the number you want at the left or in the center or at the right. So I'm clicking on the center. See, you see in the entire document at the bottom in the center you will see the page number. Page number 4, page number 5, page number 6, and then we'll scroll down and see all the page numbers. Okay, so the last page number is page number 25. So in this way we can add page number to our document.